Welcome to the Courting Happiness Podcast. This is a space where self-care becomes part of your day. A space where you learn evidence-based strategies to help your life, share it with those you love, and cultivate well-being at work. I'm your host, Dr. Kortni Alston. I'm a former news director, television reporter turned happiness scholar, TEDx speaker, and transformational trainer. I also understand hardships. While working my dream job in television, I lived a nightmare suddenly becoming a young widow after 86 days of marriage. I became committed to learning more about resilience, healing, and happiness. This is how I discovered my area of research, which is positive psychology. Now I'm living my calling of training individuals and organizations on happiness. And my new chapter begins with being happily engaged. The courting and courting happiness is about a true courtship. I like to say commitment with happiness. The K in courting stands for the vulnerability of sharing my story, inspirational interviews with phenomenal people, the infusion of positive psychology, and so much more. You'll learn how to commit to your well-being one episode at a time. I hope you subscribe and share. So, are you ready? Let's get started. Welcome to episode 122. I'm Dr. Kortni Alston. I'm so happy that you're here. Well, for the past few weeks, you might have noticed something. I did something that I hadn't done since starting the podcast, and that's that I took a two-week hiatus. Part of it was just unplanned because I ended up getting sick and, common cold kind of thing, and needed some time to really rest. But what I loved as relates to the hiatus is that allowed me to refocus, recharge, and really rejuvenate in regards to the podcast and so many other things. And so I plan on discussing the importance of time off in a future podcast, but I'm just so grateful to be back. So with that said, we're counting down to one of my favorite days of the year. And that's the International Day of Happiness. It takes place on March 20th. And to celebrate, we're counting down with a positive activity to celebrate. And it is our own digital wall of gratitude. I got to say it again. Digital wall of gratitude. I had to say it again because for the longest time, I've often thought about, what to do, how to create that. And I finally figured it out. And now you can go and visit our digital wall of gratitude by going to drkortnialston.com/podcast/episode122. That's where you'll find the wall and a chance for you to express what you're grateful for. And the best part about all of it are the scientific benefits of gratitude. According to a wonderful article, just had to qualify it, published by the Greater Good Science Center, the benefits can range from physical, psychological, and social. Now, the article, and one of the reasons why I decided to qualify it the way I do, or the way I just did, is the fact that it's written by one of the leading scholars in gratitude. His name is Dr. Robert Emmons, and I often talk about him in this podcast and so many different episodes. So more than likely, any episode, past episode that you see that is talking about the value and the benefits of gratitude, I'm talking about him and much of his work. And I do it a lot in my training sessions when I am training executives and also workplaces as it relates to workplace well-being. And so he is really an incredible scholar to be able to continue to learn more about gratitude. He has quite a few books on the subject. You can also find many of those books on the podcast in terms of the mentions, but also on the website. I have a happiness library that has a lot of different books by Dr. Emmons, as well as other scholars in positive psychology. Now, on this podcast, I often share, and as I mentioned, praise his work. And he, as you guys, you notice, as I'm talking about him, is really a true inspiration for me on so many levels. Now, some of the benefits that he mentions are physical, like It allows you to have a stronger immune system, lowers blood pressure. It allows you to, in terms of exercising more and taking better care of your health. Now, what he shares in terms of psychological, it can help with higher levels of positive emotions, more joy, and of course, happiness. Now, you can't forget about social, which can include being more helpful, compassionate, and feeling less lonely. And what I love about gratitude is that it can be both an individual and collective activity. And you can even add gratitude to your workplace. Yep, the workplace. I will tell you that as a chair of a university, I often start my faculty meetings with a strength-based question. And sometimes it can be about what they're grateful for, or what the individual's grateful for as it relates to the work culture, their coworkers, even a project. At the university level, it could look like helping a student, working with a staff member or administration or another faculty member. In a corporate structure, or if you're an entrepreneur, it could be working with a client or a customer, or just the work that you're doing as a collaborative, as a team. So the Courting Happiness podcast has created a virtual gratitude wall for you to share what you're grateful for. And like I said, you can find it on drkortneyalston.com/podcast/episode122. The wall is a place to share what you're grateful for. It's a place for you to truly reflect, to think about what you have, and to savor over experiences, people, and times that have brought you joy. You can make this both an individual and also, as I mentioned, a collective activity, but you can also share the wall with people in your life. I'm looking forward to seeing your wall grow and the gratitude that you will express as it relates to your life. I will tell you this, I'm so grateful for this community, and I'm grateful for you from all over the world who have taken part in the Courting Happiness podcast. I'm looking forward to reading the wall and seeing how gratitude is changing your life. You just know that each and every one of you listening, you're truly changing mine. And always remember that your well-being is your most important job, and I'm always here to help. Thank you for listening. Let's continue this conversation online. Email us at podcast@drkortneyalston.com. That's podcast@drkortneyalston.com. Join us on Instagram at Courting Happiness. Don't forget, that's courting with a K. Also, I hope you join our private Facebook community. You can find us at Courting Happiness Podcast Community. Our private Facebook group is a safe haven to share, meet more people looking to build positive relationships, focus on well-being, and create a happier life. Now, are you ready to spread happiness? We hope you subscribe and share this podcast with your family, friends, coworkers, and all the important people in your world. We release a new episode every Thursday. Congratulations on your continued commitment to your Courting Happiness journey. Thank you so much for listening. We want you to be well, be happier, and be kinder to yourself. We can't wait to see you next week.